Chinese flute, Dietze, the Bangdi. The Chinese bamboo flute is the classic sound of the optimism of rural China. It has a range of over 2 octaves, perfectly in tune in equal temperament. It is capable of quite amazing feats of virtuosity, with fast double tonguing and very smooth portamento, the kind that is completely impossible on a keyed flute. The instrument has an extra hole near the embouchure hole, which can be covered with a small film of bamboo paper. This paper is attached wet, and when it dries, it's extremely tightly stretched and vibrates in sympathy. The more so, the louder the notes are played. This creates a highly distinctive sound. Well, think about how paper does the same job in a kazoo. This sound is quintessentially Chinese. When the player does not require that timbre, he or she simply removes the bamboo paper and covers the hole with any kind of tape. The instrument then sounds pretty much like a normal transverse flute. The next member of the Dietze family is the Qudi. The Qudi is a lower-pitched version of the Bangdi, a fourth lower in pitch, in fact, and otherwise is similar in every possible respect. The Xiao, one of my favourites, the historic flute of the philosophers and poets. Played vertically, it is a notch flute, with the sound produced very much the same way as with a Japanese shakuhachi or a South American kena. It has a very soft and quiet sound, rather liquid and pensive in quality. Very much an indoor instrument that will work with quiet dialogue or in intimate or romantic situations. The Jun. This is the sound of the mists of time, if ever there was one. This terracotta marvel has been around in the regions that were to become China since at least 5000 BC, and there are perfect specimens of that age in Chinese museums that play perfectly well. It's a reminder of how far ahead of the rest of the world in arts and technology China was when Europe was just moving from the Iron Age to the Bronze Age. The Jun is pear-shaped and is therefore very resonant with a voice-like sound, rounded like a breathy sine wave. It has a range of not much more than 1 octave, but still very useful and usable for a simple and heartfelt theme. It also makes for a very pleasant alternative to the Bangdi and the Qudi. soft like the Xiao, but with a less breathy, purer tone. The Sheng. This is a free reed mouth organ that has been around for many centuries, although it was heavily redesigned during the early 20th century, like a number of Chinese instruments. It would originally have been made from a dried-out gourd used as a resonator, with bamboo pipes emerging from it, with thin, tiny reeds just cut into the side, similar to how we make a sound by blowing through a blade of grass between our thumbs. It now has a forest of metal pipes, all with metal reeds, all resting in a hardwood or metal air chamber. It has a wide range, a huge dynamic range from near silence to almost deafening, and can fulfill the roles of the oboe or the trumpet in the Western orchestra, but with the plus that it can play chords. However, if you want that emotive over the hills and far away mood, like a lone cowboy playing his mouth organ by a campfire, then darn it, the Sheng's the sound you'll be after. Bawu. The Chinese have long been keen to incorporate folk instruments from some of the more remote regions into the unifying Chinese orchestra. In this way, the bawu, originally a simple bamboo pipe with a single free reed, has been modified, modernized, and introduced into the palette of sounds of the Chinese orchestra. Very much like the bawu, is a minority people instrument from Yunnan province mainly. Instruments very similar to the bawu in Hulusi coexist in Burma, Vietnam and northern Thailand. Where the Hulusi differs from the bawu is that it is made in a greater variety of keys and that it uses a gourd as a resonating chamber to offset the narrower diameter of the instrument's sounding pipe. The sound is thinner and perhaps more poignant as a result. The gourd resonator more than makes up for the lost volume. But if you're looking for poignancy at a kind of alto female vocal pitch, like a mother singing a lullaby, look no further, my friends, than the bawu and Hulusi. Thank you. So, if the Bawu and Hulusi will lull you to sleep and to dream of the mist-covered hills beyond the clouds, then wake up now, because the Suona could not be more different. It is, frankly, terrifying. Being a double-reed shawm, we know that shawms have always been the loudest of all woodwind instruments, used in military, ceremonial and religious contexts. They exist in one form or other all over the world. 2.5 octave range, they exist in several sizes and are fully chromatic. Characterised by enormous sweeping glissandi and non-stop playing using circular breathing, if you play one in California, you'll hear it in Nevada. Truly Chinese and amazing and uncompromising. You will hear it above the swords, cannons and horses' hooves in any battle scene, including the ones in Mulan.